Hi traders, I just made over $9,000 day trading stocks in less than 1 hour. Let me show you how. IMMU is my main candidate today. Stock is down 20%. Now it's a $14 stock. Yesterday it was at 18. The thing I like about it is the first 2 1-minute candles here. Now, as you can see, we are just 5 minutes into the trading day. These are all 1 minute candles, and the stock have moved up very strong in the first two candles. Now the topic tail suggests it's failing, and now it's coming back down, and the reversal point should be $14. It's a whole number. There's a lot of buyers lining up at whole numbers. Now look at the buyer side here. You're going to see them lining up. Here we go. We're coming down now. Look at the buyers at 14, actually 14.01. You have 2100 shares, 20,000 shares, and if it's going to come down under that, I'm going to short it. Just notice the buyers and the sellers. It's a bit spready. It's a big mover. It's a very big mover. And if it's going to come down under 14, the support of the whole number, I'm going to short it, 4,000 shares. Watch it now. Now, just came down. I'm short, 4,000 shares. Nice initial move, 20 cent, 25 cents maybe, but it's a bit spready. So of course, my target should be much more than that. I'm risking approximately 30 cents, maybe a bit more, maybe 40. I'm watching Tesla for a short under 327.50. And now I'm short, just moved under. Now, the nice thing about Tesla is that it started with a gap down. And again, the same as IMMU, as you can see, it moved up, failed to move higher, came down, came back to the 327.50, found some support there. And you know, semi-whole numbers like 0.50 are important, just like whole numbers. Well, not exactly as whole numbers, but you will find a lot of buyers lining up at semi-whole numbers. So if the reversal stop, reversal point happens to be very, very close to a whole number or to a semi-whole number, that would be better. Now, Tesla just moved under the lows, still is looking good. I was risking approximately 2, maybe 2.5 points. So that was a big risk, and now I have almost 2 points. So my target should be somewhere at 325, maybe under 325, and it's getting close. We're just 30 cents above, and here we go, and under. Great, great. What a great move in Tesla. Almost 3 points now, getting ready now. Took my partial, a little bit more than I expected really. Just left 200 shares now, and Tesla made a very, very nice breakdown. So Tesla is just about to pull back up, and I'm thinking whether I should stay with the last 200 shares. No, I think it's going to continue. It looks like there's a lot of pressure, downside pressure. Popped up a little bit under from the lows. Now we see a small pullback. Well, if it's going to continue for a new low, I'm going to reduce my size, and we do. Look at that. Oh, so nice. This is nice. 4 points. 4 points. A 4 point trade. Still have 200 shares left. Getting ready for another now. Okay, reduced my size with another 100 shares. I'm seeing a pullback coming. So I am just leaving 100 shares. Well, I was wrong. It continued to a new low. Watching IMMU here again. Now I am short 4,000 shares. Initially it moved down, as you can see here. That was very, very nice. But now it's really just consolidating. It's just going sideways. And I'm a little bit concerned that it's going to continue here over the 1420, which is that area right here. So if it will, I'm going to stop it. But since I'm a little bit concerned, I'm thinking about lowering my size. Okay, it's coming down now. I'm going to lower my size by 2,000 shares right now. Okay, took a small loss. Took a small loss with 2,000 shares. And I still hope it's going to come down, but right now it's unknown. It's just going sideways. It could go either way. Now it's down 20%, so most likely down, but who knows. IMMU is still holding here, and I'm getting ready to see it coming down a bit, and then I'm going to add back. So I reduced my size earlier by 2,000 shares, if I'm going to see it coming a little bit lower, and like here, okay, I'm adding, added back another 2000 shares, and I will add again if it moves under 1370 approximately. So I will add another 2000 shares for my short side. So I'm growing my size now based on its actual direction. Look at this breakdown here under 1370. I'm going to add another 2000 shares if it comes down under that point here. Almost now. Watch the buyers. Well, I made a mistake. Look at the number of buyers here at 69. There's a whole bunch of buyers at 69. I didn't see that when I clicked the button. I should have. It was there. Now I'm just hoping it's going to come down. I should have shorted it under 69, not under 70. My initial short point was supposed to be 70. That was okay, but I should have watched the buyer's side, and I did not. Now look at the buyers here, 5,500 shares at the buyer side at 16 now. Now I just have to pray that it's going to come down under that. Now watch the buyers, watch the sellers at all times. I should have done that myself. I did not. I was kind of excited to see it coming down under 70 and adding. Now I am 6,000 shares short. And look at the buyers now moving up to 72. You don't want to see them anymore. I mean, I don't want, I'm wondering whether they're going to stay. No, they did not move back to the 69. Watch the buyers. Watch the buyers, all sides. The left side is the buyers, the right side is the sellers. It's a bit spread, as you can see, approximately 10 cents right now. But there's still a lot of buyers at 69. You can see them still waiting there. Now, another important thing to watch is whether they're going to renew their quantity. Right now, there's 4,300 shares, and it's bouncing between 70-something to 72 to 78. Now I don't see them anymore. You don't see them. But when it's going to come down, you probably they're probably going to show themselves. So right now you see the buyers at 70. No buyers at 69. Are they gone? No, they're still there. You see, the same buyer with 4,300 shares is still there. You need to watch at all times the buyers, the sellers, and the time and sale, the actual trades that are taking place. So far, we did not come down. That was a mistake. I should have added when it was under 69. I'm still waiting for it. The technical formation looks great. Here comes the 69 again. Now less. No renewal. It's coming down. Look at the numbers. And we're under. We just moved under 69. And the guy that was buying at 69, he's no longer there, which is very, very important because he did not renew his quantity. Now, if you wonder who's the one who's buying this stock when it's down 22.5%, well, these are most likely short sellers who are trying to cover. Probably some guys who shorted it earlier at a much higher price than I did, or maybe not, I don't know, and now taking their profits, actually covering their trades. So now I'm watching the buyers and sellers again, and now you can see some buyers lining up at 68, but I don't think it's the same buyers because the quantity is not the same. And now it's coming back down to the 60. It's good. Some buyers are coming in, but there's more downside pressure. Look at the sellers now at 65. More seller pressure. And we're just moving to 64. Look at the sellers moving down a cent. It's very important. Just at all time, watch the buyers, watch the sellers, concentrate on the power of the buyers, the power of the sellers. Now you see more sellers coming down, 61, and a small bounce. Again, continue watching the buyers and the sellers, and now we're down to the 50s. Great. I'm waiting for the stock to come down, and I think that if we can move under the 50, then we're very likely to move under the lows, which is 1330, as you can see here. So I'm giving it a chance to move under 50, but there is an issue there. 0.50, semi-all number. I mentioned that earlier. We could find a lot of buyers lining up there. Now look at the sellers coming down. They just did to 50 something. Now we have a small pullback. That's no big deal. It's a small volume. As you can see, at the time and sale, there are hundreds of shares there. So if the stock's moving up 10 cents by hundreds of shares, I don't care. Now watch the sellers coming down to 63. Very important. Look, two sellers, 2,500 each. And as expected, came down a little bit. Again, watch the sellers, watch the buyers. The buyers are at 50. 58, 57 now. Sellers just moved to 57. Good. Look at the buyers lining up at 51 now. The same thing we saw earlier at 14.01. Now we can see the same at 13.51. And why is that? Because the semi-whole number, 0.50. Those who are professional are lining up at 51, not at 50, because they know there will be a lot of buyers at 50. So they go 1 cent higher. And again, if you ask yourself, who are those buyers? These are people who probably shorted it earlier and now trying to cover their shorts, meaning buying. They shorted, they sold, and we ran there. And now, I believe, we have a free ride under the lows. Okay, small pullback. Again, watching the buyers. Some buyers came there, but not too many. We're still holding here at around the 50s. Just try to move under, and here we go again, under the 50s. I'm getting ready for my partial, because once it breaks down under the lows, I would like to get my partial somewhere over there. Again, watch the sellers now. Now you can see the sellers moving down, 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 down. Here we go. Come to puppy, come to puppy. Yes, here at the lows, at 30. A lot of buyers at the lows, as expected, always. The low is a support area. The low is a support area, and we just touched the lows, 1330, and bounced. Look at the number of buyers that lined up at 1330. Very important to watch that. You know, when I'm trading a stock like that, I don't watch the chart. I don't care about the chart. The only thing I'm watching is here, the level 2. The buyers on the left side, the sellers on the right side, and the time and sale. The time and sale gives you a clue of how many trades are executed at that number. When you see a zero like now, that means less than 100. 100, it's just one. So the quantity right now is very, very low. And try and watch if the quantity is growing as it comes down and if the speed of the transactions is getting faster. Right now, I don't see any change and it still holds. So it's low volume, just popped up 15, 20 cents. Nothing special about it, very likely to return to the lows. There's a lot of pressure there. The stock is down 23%. People are very much afraid, and you know, fear works much better than greed. Now again, watch the buyers, watch the sellers. You see the buyers are right now at 41, and here we go, under the lows. Oh, this is great, this is great. Now I'm getting ready for my partial. I'm going to take a 5,000 share partial, and we're under. Okay, come on, continue, please continue. We have a new low at 1320 and under 13. Oh my goodness, look at that. Look at this crash down now. There's a lot of sellers now. And at any pullback now, I'm going to click that button and cover 5,000 shares. Sellers at under 13 now. Now moving up. First sign of a pullback. First sign of pullback. It moved over 13. I clicked that button. What a huge trade, and I'm leaving 1,000 shares. Guys, I'm having a great day, leaving so far 1,000 shares with IMMU. Great test trade in Tesla too, up $9,000 in 21 minutes. Thank you for watching our video. Before you go, we invite you to join the TradeNet trading room for a free 14-day trial. TradeNet has educated more than 30,000 professional traders worldwide since 2004, and its trading room is one of the world's leading trading communities. Click here to start your free trial. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel where you can view many more stock trading videos. Questions or comments, please submit them below.